We got some. It's not exactly tiebreaker. It's called last chance. And basically, if you lose, you're out. If you don't lose, you still have to play more matches to see if you can make it in. Once again, I'm Llama Down Under. I'm going to be joined by Clairvoyance, and we've got Vengeance, or I've got his Twitter tag up there, on stats. How you doing, Clairvoyance?
10 seconds remaining.
Not great, by the sounds of things. Let me just double check that everything is in order with Team Secret. You have your mic muted, Clairvoyance. Try again.
Team Secrets turn to ban.
I can now. Most excellent. Let me just tone you up a little bit since you're a little quiet, and then let's get this show on the road. How excited are you to see Secret versus Na'Vi?
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Yeah, it's been really interesting. Both OG and Secret, after some great performances, having a bit of trouble, and actually Liquid, who, I mean, I managed to cast Liquid falling to teams like Alternate, and then kicking OG's bum a little. But I'm excited. Na'Vi, obviously their roster shuffles, their win rate has gone up quite a bit since they did have this shuffle. Albeit, I don't know if they've been super, super tested, but we're in, and we're going to be seeing, obviously, an IO ban, and then kind of Doom. I guess I'm a bit surprised that Slaughter, but they banned both the Tiny and the IO against Na'Vi.
Yeah, this is probably a product of playing a lot of scrims with them. Maybe Na'Vi is,
and
has demonstrated.
I don't hear you again, Clairvoyance. I'm not quite sure if you...
Pardon me. I was just trying to set up my Dota TV. It's supposed to be enabled, correct?
Yes. Oh, goodness. Okay. Yes. Check that your mic is on. Sorry that I didn't give you the pre-warm-up little thing.
Oh, no worries. I should have it down pat by now, but just wanted to go on to say this is definitely a product of scrims and practice games that we probably don't know about as much as spectators on the side. Maybe Na'Vi has demonstrated in the past against that even if the Wisp is banned, they'll say, hey, Diarra plays a pretty fine Tiny on the safe lane. Go for it anyway. Maybe they took a win or something like that. So now Darkseer is going to be the first pick for Secret.
Yeah, and this is something which obviously Misery has a lot of experience on. It's kind of funny when you look over Misery's games for this patch, it's a lot of Darkseer, a lot of Slaughter, and a lot of Darkseer. But it makes a lot of sense with the prevalence of how melee carries are popular right now, Darkseer having a lot of utility. And Na'Vi open with Dazzle. I wonder if they'll pair that with Slaughter and go full minus armor or pick up the Radiant Shadow Fiend.
It's very possible. I mean, with the Dazzle, it's definitely one of the best pickups. They can alternatively go for the Slaughter or something like the Gyrocopter, which counters the Darkseer in the lane. A lot of options open for them. And Nightstalker is going to be the pickup.
Yeah, not what I was expecting. He's one of those heroes where he was very popular at the beginning of 6.85, and he's really dropped off as the patches had time to marinate. But Na'Vi saying they're gonna go with him. He can be support. He could actually be their mid as well. I've seen a couple of these CIS teams run the mid Nightstalker to great success. He just gets so much work done, and he does the whole "I'm gonna leave my lane every time it's nighttime and allow our supports to get extra farm," which I think is obviously highly effective. So really strange or interesting pickups from Na'Vi.
I hope it's not a mid Nightstalker against the. I mean, for one, they're dealing with a Darkseer, which means the offlane side of Secret will always be safe lane is always going to be showing their carry or the carry plus support. Team means that if the mid lane leaves as well, it actually allows a Secret to move around the map and play relatively safe. And if you get much in the early game, or in the mid game even, you could have a pretty big liability on your hands going late, trying to scale evenly with enemy cores. Very well be one, but in my head I think it's at least 3 position or 4 position. But this stand-in Ogrizok 11, I have no idea who this guy is. Maybe you covered it before, but I might have missed it.
Oh, isn't that Envy?
I'm pretty sure that Ogrizok 11 on Na'Vi side, orange player.
Oh, okay. I have different names. Sorry, I have Envy showing up as a stand on my screen. Which position? Because this is Na'Vi's full roster. I see Alt Style, Seneko, Dendi, Dichara, and Axmo.
Oh, it says Axmo. It says Oz.
Yeah.
Ogrizok 11.
He shows up as, I mean, this is classic Dota TV woes where the ticket is applied differently for different people. So I do see it's Axmo, and they've been playing with him for a bit now, and he'll be playing in the offlane usually.
I think we can both agree that he's got the female bathroom sign. for his avatar.
Yes, he does, which is... It's a choice, but maybe it's one of those that it'll strike fear into the enemy's heart, unlike this squirrel that Dendi is rocking. You know, not very scary, but getting into the picks, obviously Bane, this is something that Pylodi plays a bunch of, as does Dendi, so it's, I mean, it's a strong pickup, it's good at stopping these the aggression, as long as Nightstalk doesn't silence out the Bane, and it's probably something they'll pair with another support where if you silence one, the other can save them, always.
Team secrets turn to ban.
And the Meepo ban out, I mean, that one speaks for itself, along with the Huskar, you never want that paired up with your Dazzle. I have to say I'm a little disappointed, I was hoping to see some Meepo action, as difficult as that is to catch on the camera.
10 seconds remaining.
It is very possible, but
Na'vi's turn to
not so much anymore.
Yeah, and it's something where, as you pointed out, this could just be an effect of Scrims, or also, obviously, everybody's seen how powerful Secret is on that Meepo. Does feel like it's something where you need a really good plan on how to deal with Meepo, and almost your entire draft has to be around that, and then of course Secret can just not pick it, so nice of Na'vi to ban it out. And the PL as well, this one strikes me as a bit weird. I feel like he's not one of the most popular carries right now, you know, he's not a juggernaut that's seen a lot of play.
Yeah, I think, well, the PL play, I think, is it's been making some waves, as you mentioned with OG, one of the teams that are somewhat falling off, or seemingly falling off. They like the hero a lot, and of course, both these teams so far, they have a lot of single target focus and like a one-time instantaneous things. I did think the Ember Spear was gonna come out, but I didn't see why Secret ban it. So maybe Na'vi were kind of forced into it, thinking that maybe Secret wanted the Ember and wanted to take it away, sort of thing. But there's a lot of aggression coming up in that lineup, and I gotta say, before the Ember, they definitely had a lot of single target centric abilities. PL would have been pretty.
Yeah, and then Team Secret go with the AA, Talon Dazzle, but he's not going to be getting a lot of heal. It's kind of interesting as well, because obviously Dazzle can shallow grave people to stop them from shattering, so they're kind of arguably a bit counters to each other. But now with this pickup of Queen of Pain, I feel like Na'vi have a really mobile lineup, and while Fiend's Grip and Nightmare obviously decent ways of locking people down, that's kind of Secret's only ways. Cold Feet not going to reliably proc. Vacuum, while it technically is a mini, it's not a mini stun. It technically holds you or something. It disrupts you. It's not really a good way of controlling an Ember Spirit and a Queen of Pain.
Right. And a Night Stalker who's going to be moving at the 400 movement speed. It's going to be even harder that way as well. You mentioned with Lockdown, there's somewhat lackluster on the side of Secret, but I believe the next tier has to be a strength based, and there it is actually. Something that can withstand the initial onslaught coming out of Na'vi. They have a set of pretty decent 3 cores. I personally think that Nightstalker might synergize with both of them, but Ember Spirit and Queen of Pain are somewhat magic centric. And again, one hit wonders to an extent with Queen of Pain, so
yeah,
picking quite a nice pickup.
It's always nice to pick the Wraith King into heroes that, you know, they want to drop their toolkit and kill everyone. Wraith King just comes back. But it still does feel like Secret, they have a lot of... They have great individual target potential. I feel like they need a mid that ties this all together. Maybe it's just someone simple like the Lina to help with the Darkseer AoE. But Wraith King, obviously, he doesn't do AoE damage. He's also single target. And, you know, maybe you kill the Ember or you kill the Quap. If the rest of their team picks you off, Na'vi's going to be happy about that, even if they lose one.
In the mid hero that ties things up, adds to the pool. I think so far with the Windrunner as well as the Evoker being banned out, as you mentioned, Lina's a high possible hero. I think Alchemist is also a really possible pick here as well, because I feel like Na'vi, when it comes to the mid game stage where the Alchemist actually has the highest net worth on the board, if it gets, I feel like they're gonna have a real hard time killing this Alchemist hero with all his regen, with all his tank ability, depending on the items that come out as well. So something they could look into. I think Weeha in general might prefer the Lina more. The options are there.
Yeah, and I have to say, the Invoker ban coming out, we've been seeing that guy picked up so much, and it's been so fantastic, but sadly, not today. Clockwork gonna be the last pickup, so Na'vi's got themselves actually a really scary lineup. I feel
very
like their lineup's...
Yeah.
Right, it can go super early, and I don't doubt they'll make space for this Ember Spirit to get a lot of farm.
I think Secret can actually consider aggressive tri-laning here, though. The tri-lane of Na'vi itself is not that strong. I mean, if they pick the Queen of Pain there as well, what can happen is their mid lane matchup against Ember, if it's going to be... never mind that thought, because Dendi is almost always going to take the Queen of Pain here to the middle line in this situation. Assuming that, again, you can pick the Lina, but it's a little bit tougher now, I gotta say. With the Clockwork on the field, and you have Nightstalker, Ember Spirit, and Clockwork, they're all three heroes are so good against Lina. They might be forced into something else, like the Alchemist, or something even tankier, which stands the damage better.
Yeah, and the problem is, I feel like even an Alc, he's not a hero that exactly has great stat gain, right? He's going to be able to be taken out by these as well. Yeah, the Chemical Rage should keep him alive a bit longer, but I think that Queen of Pain, Clockwork, Nightstalker, that's enough burst for an Alc. And it's worrisome, but as you said, it's going to be the Alc, so we're going to be getting into this one, guys. Welcome to Game 1 between Team Secret and Na'Vi. Let's hope it's a good one.
You know, I think if they didn't pick Clockwork as the last hero there, they definitely would have picked. I think it synergizes better with their lineup, and there wouldn't be so many tools. Lina playing against Nightstalker and Clockwork and Ember Spirits, like, there's like, you have to watch out for three heroes being off the map, because anytime one of them rotate to a lane with one other hero, like plus one, even Dazzle, Queen of anything like that, they can actually get the kill on the Lina. And just the potential of disrupting her combo allows Secret to say, okay, we should just try to scale better. We actually have some good heroes, like we can pull Aghanim's on. Even Ancient Apparition getting an Axe pull is going to be really game-changing this game. So they have that option. And of course, you just need a hero that can survive and farm and scale. And Alchemist just gives them all three of these options.
I was actually going to say I was a bit worried about Secret's lineup, because AA is traditionally, you know, AA, Wraith King, two heroes that take a little bit longer to kind of come online. They need a bit more farm. But as you pointed out, if they decide to toss AA an early Aghanim Scepter through the Alchemist, he's a lot more useful earlier on. And also, he can certainly teamfight earlier on. It's just a matter of, I mean, it's just hard to hit the AA blasts every time.
Yeah, I actually don't know how they're going to approach this. I've only seen Weehaw play Alchemist a few times, and the few times I did, I think he did go for the Radiance build. Could actually be good this game as well. There's not a lot of Manta Illusion solutions. Again, heroes like Dazzle, Clockwork, and Nightstalker, these heroes will crumble to split push a lot of the times, especially illusion-based split push. So we will have to see how he wants to approach this and get some farm. But it looks like Secrets are rotating as 5 for now.
I really do like this. Let's quickly introduce the players before we have that maybe level 1 clash that we'll be looking forwards to. On the Dazzle, of course, we've got Altstyle, we've got Nightstalker being played up by Seneko, Dendi on that Queen of Pain, Ember Spirit being played by Dicha Ra, and finally Clockwork on Axmo. And tossing it over to you to introduce Secret as they go hunting for this Dazzle.
We got Paladai sitting on his signature hero, planning a ward on the Bane Elemental. We have Adlib Mayor, otherwise known as EE Sama or Eternal Envy himself, coming in with the Fire Blast. Weehaw on the Alchemist, not Meeple this time. The Mastermind, Boupier himself, the Ancient Apparition Sentry Warning Camp, and we have Misery rotating back to the safe lane with his Darkseer, level 1 Iron Shells.
Yeah, and this will be interesting. As you said, it does look like they're running an aggressive tri-lane.
And, very, very strong tri-lane.
Yeah, it's something where I feel like as long as they get the Wraithfire Blast on someone, they should be able to turn that into a kill pretty easily with Chilling Touch. The only concern maybe is the follow-up, but again, because it looks like it's going to be, you know, Nightstalker might have to be doing some roaming, Dazzle's not going to hit you hard back, exactly, so.
You're concerned about the follow-up, but when you have everybody in a tri-lane scenario, or even this situation, which is double, coming in with double damage at level 1, it's going to be scary no matter what, and I still fear that even with Ember Dazzle, they're more or less sacked in this lane if the Nightstalker doesn't help.
Yep. Now, I also wonder, I feel like Ember, he's a hero who sometimes... Oh, okay. Never mind. We just got dual mid action. Never mind. False alarm. I feel like Ember Spirit, these days, he's a hero that he sometimes takes a bit longer to come online because he does want that Battle Fury. He does want maybe drums or bots before that. Do you think this is just a game to go kind of the fighting Ember? You pick up treads, maybe you pick up drums, you try to go ham since the rest of your team's online?
I think you can actually play it both ways. But to be completely honest with you, I'm not sure how well he will actually have that process letting those items go. Because as you can see, the harassment's already coming out. Ember Spirit is a hero on the safe lane. It's actually not that strong to fight up against other lanes, like even number scenario. He's good at killing the offlaner solo with the support. Not good at actually fighting directly head on.
Yeah, and we can see Dendi taking quite a bit of harassment in mid. This Brain Sap, it's quite dirty. It just means you can stand up to harassment so much better than other people. Oh, Dendi, he might be thinking, no, he just wants the C. I thought maybe he'd try to go for a kill there, but playing it safe. And he's having a rough time.
He's getting very low, yeah.
Yeah, he's already used his salve as well, so, and he's still in the acid spray. Maybe can't, you know, he's probably just min-maxing there, though. thing we see pretty commonly. And now with the Bane headed down, this tri-lane starts to become really scary, as you mentioned, for D2Ra.
Since a nice addition of Mangles, these strength heroes, you can always check their mana beforehand. But now, with the Mango available, he's gonna go for another target.
Yeah, the Cold Feet doesn't proc, they actually end up throwing it onto D2Ra, and they might have enough damage here with just auto attacks. The Shallow Grave comes out immediately. Well played from Artstyle on the lost auto attack too soon. So that was scary, and as you mentioned, that's welcome to this tri-lane. Do you think it's something where they should try to rotate, since obviously being up against the Darkseer, it's not great, but it's a bit better?
No, I don't think they have any options to rotate. Whatever lane they have set up this game will follow them, and it's just gonna be a nightmare slash hell kind of thing going on for them, so this is the best they can actually have. And again, one of the deficiencies of picking Ember is one of these things where you just get crushed in.
Now, taking a look-see at mid with Seneko coming in, this is helping to zone Weeha a little bit. Obviously, it's a matchup where the Alc kind of just throws down the acid spray, gets a bunch of lost hits. Dendi's doing well on denies, but it's always going to be a bit rough. And I think the name of the game here just has to be stopping him from also getting these bounties. Because otherwise, the Alc, I mean, you can really slow down his farm if you stop him from getting those bounties. It just does mean that your bottom lane and top lane can't necessarily get as much health as they want.
Woods picked up for Eternal Envy here now, so the aggression can come out in a slightly faster form. And again, D2Ra and Artstyle, they're getting zoned out on their own safe. This is really just a sacked safe lane, and time, I actually imagine I imagine the Bane to leave as well. He's kind of sitting here sapping a lot of EXP. I think around the 4-minute mark, they're gonna try to contest runes more and play more aggressive at the middle lane.
Now,
I'm really curious to see how Weeha takes this, because he's got the level 1 unstable concoction at level 4. So I'm assuming he's gonna do the Miracle build, the Solar Crest.
Yeah, I would love to see that. It's definitely more exciting than the Radiance build. But at the same time, Weeha, he's going to be a little bit careful. Although they have great ward protection. I have to say, I also love this because when you look at Secret, they've got wards here. They were blocking that camp previously. They've really cut off a lot of things that Na'Vi could be doing, right? They can't be stacking and kind of sacking the bottom lane. They can't be ganking mid because of this great ward protecting Weeha over here. I'm just not sure what's the right thing to do. And down in bottom, that's our first blood. Ember Spirit goes down. There was some Cold Feet chilling touch action, and that'll be that.
Fire Blast, probably one of the best spells to synergize with for the Cold Feet. It not only stuns for the 2 seconds, but it also slows for the 2 seconds after. Which means you don't actually have to have any points into Ice Vortex, so quite convenient for dueling.
Yeah, it's a really easy setup for that. So let's take a look at top. It's a lane we haven't focused on too much just because there's been so much aggression. I feel like this is one of those traditional, everybody gets kind of what they want out of the lane. But I'd be more worried about the super farm Darkseer, because this is going to be a Darkseer with both levels and items going into this mid game, where it does feel like Secret getting a great start in that bottom lane and the Alc going to be ready because he's an Alchemist.
Well, it looks like they kind of want to chase in Misery here. They recognize that he doesn't have a TP.
Yeah, but they don't have the hookshot yet up on Axemo. Turns out you don't need that. You just run him down with the battery assault. He actually doesn't quite catch him in the cogs. And now Seneko is caught in a bad position. The TPs are coming in. They also, oh no, they don't have TPs. They're still trying to go into Misery, but Puppy and Envy maybe showing them, a world of pain. There's going to be one going down. Seneko manages to get the TP out, and they don't have another stun which can latch on him. But a costly death for Axemo on that clockwork, and yeah, it freed up a little bit of space for D2Ra on this bottom lane, but I don't think that was at all what they wanted.
Na'Vi not like this, really just missing the kill, and of course, again, they did force the TP, so D2Ra does get space at bottom, but that's definitely not what they wanted ultimately.
They give it an aggressive go, they even use the Sonic Wave Weeha, he doesn't have the Chemical Rage, and he's gonna go down. Just really nice play there from Dendi, taking advantage of all the denies he'd been able to get, and yeah, also the initial dual lane, of course, sapping some of that experience on the Alc. I'm impressed. Either way, I'm still concerned though. We've got Seneko, he is level 3 running around in his first nighttime, he's made one kill latch. He needs to get maybe a couple more, I think, to be, you know, super useful.
Oh, and they look like, they wanted to do something on the lost vision at the edge of that ward there. Yeah. In the meantime, Dendi's gonna go for top rune, but Axemo already took it. Dendi's not gonna be happy about that.
Yeah. And speaking of not being happy, Misery, he gets Searing Chained up, he's gonna get auto attack down here. He tries to use the vacuum, they just need one more, and they manage to get it. Helps that Seneko had a DD, just a little bit there. But I was really surprised that Misery ended up being the one coming back down to that bottom lane.
Yeah, you know, they were doing really well, but I guess they wanted to just use the efficiency of their TP, the teleportation top between the two heroes, the Wraith King and the Apparition. I think the lane swap is bad at this point. I think it would have been nice if they would have been able to stay in this lane and pressure the Yara more, but it's still free farm on the Wraith.
Yeah, and we've also got, I have to say, 4 secret good levels coming out of Puppy. It's something where, I mean, he had to be the one actually staying in the tri-lane, but the fact that he's level 4, it's something where you often see the Ancient Apparition being forced to run around and stack and do all these errands for the team. So it's nice to see him getting some. But Darkseer running back down to that bottom lane, and all the heroes for a secret chilling in their jungle, of course trying to get up some stacks for Weeha. Yeah, this is going to give Dijira a little bit of space, although he has a lot of catching up to do at 19 and 4.
I think against Darkseer, though, he should have a relatively easy time. I mean, if Nightstalker is missing off the map and Darkseer is going up against Ember Spirit, you just have to play way far back.
Yeah.
Because Ember is one of those heroes. Oh, in the meantime, Wraith King.
Oh.
Yeah, he goes down. The Clockwork spots him out in the woods with the Nightstalker nighttime vision. Simply go on top of him with the cogs as well as battery and just assault him down.
And it looks like Dendi
might go down as well here.
Yeah, Dendi has found more. They've got the void. They just need 2 more auto attacks, but he's regenning up.
Oh, the creep so close almost to the neutral got deny, that. Actually.
So well played there, catching out a number of people using that extra nighttime vision. And this is what we talked about. It's really hit or miss when you pick up a Nightstalker, but they're making it work on Na'Vi. And slowly but surely, it's starting to pull them ahead. I hear a cloak shot onto the bottom lane. It's Pylai die, but the battery assault, no match for the Nightmare. Can Sineko catch up? It just turned daytime, so that would be a no. So well played.
Coming in, so they might get this Nightstalker here with double Iron Shell.
It's looking like it's an echo just burning down super fast, as you mentioned. Darkseer actually gets the last hit, so that's gonna be fine, so.
The Nightstalker was taking 180 magic damage per second during the duration of the stun. To mention the stun damage, Eternal Envy actually tried to get the last hit, but he realized that the damage over time was too strong.
Just outhits him a little bit, so taking a look at the net worth, Dendi is actually still at the top of it. Obviously the 2 kills help with that a lot, as he does have a bunch of CS, but they're making stacks for Weeha. I mean, obviously these wards gonna help them sort of contest them. It's feeling like they're gonna have to come next nighttime, really keep check on this Alchemist, because otherwise he's just gonna fall out of control.
Yeah, they definitely have to suppress him somehow. I think the best way to do this would actually just be pushing in into the towers as much as possible during daytime and just go for a smoke at nighttime. At nighttime, not only are Secret disadvantaged, but they have a huge advantage with the Nightstalker as well.
Yeah.
Because Secret don't have the aggressive heroes that can just run in all the time. As mentioned before earlier in the draft, they don't have too many disabled setups aside from the Wraith King going in.
Yeah, it's actually a really weird draft. I'm kind of expecting Wraith King to go Blink next, but he may also just want that Omelette up soon, as you mentioned. Just depending on how soon the push comes, I can see him itemizing differently. And they have Ward Vision. They might be able to steal these from Weeha. I mean, that itself would be a little bit of a win.
Definitely looks like they want to do something here. With Clockwork in position, I think Dendi can actually farm this thing up.
Yeah,
this
unfortunately.
Is a nice game, but Secret want to protect it, so they're coming in.
Yeah, and I think some of their wards, the ward in mid, may have seen that. Here comes Envy. Can he get the Wraith Fire Blast off onto Dendi? Oh, we've also got AA around. Weeha is taking it, and he's taking no damage because of that Chemical Rage. They're going to throw a rocket. Gets one. Not enough. And everybody going to be leaving the dire jungle, as we say that. So.
You know, I would have said this is still a nice move from Na'Vi, since they forced a whole bunch of heroes top that didn't really want to be there. Like the Wraith King, for example. Now he's farming neutrals. Not something he should be doing right now when he's level 7. But, Ember wasn't free farming. He was actually looking for an engagement as well. He lost some time out, and as a result, like, other teams really get the best of the engagement.
Yeah.
They're up. So Neko actually catches level 6 at Pops of Darkness for reasons I do not know.
I was going to comment on that. It is something where sometimes you're just striking the fear into your opponent's team.
But he's showing himself in lane.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know.
Maybe hoping to capitalize, maybe trying to make them think that they can't do other wards and so on. I don't think that was on purpose at this point in the game.
Yeah, he might have skilled and clicked again. I don't know. He seems like a little higher EXP, but
yeah.
Regardless, they're at bottom now. It looks like there's going to be an engagement for sure here this time.
Now Misery, he is going to use that sword. He actually runs down, running into the creep wave. He's probably just buying time for his team to get there. He gets a nice wall out. Does he have the vacuum? He's silenced though. Going to be a little bit of an AA ball. It's going to hit on two, but Misery's already gone. Sinead goes quickly to follow. And now in comes Dendi. He does have that sonic wave up, of course. Let's see what he can do. Shallowgrave onto Art Style. And Puppy is Nightmared, but Rockets, they're just going to tickle them. Envy, he's coming in from behind. I think Art Style's going to be taking a Wraithfire Blast if Envy has anything to say about it. But now he's under tower. DJ Raw going in deep onto Puppy. He's the one who takes the Wraithfire Blast. Heal comes out onto him, but suddenly this team of Secret, they're on the back lines. Puppy falling. Envy has to be careful. He might bone his second life. We see Pilot Die go down, and I think they're going to bone at least one life onto Envy. He's actually turning around trying to hit onto Dendi, but there's no such luck. And I think easily a second life here. They've got slows. They actually throw out the unstable concoction on two, but Dendi, he just has to line this up and he can get a sonic wave on Envy and the entire creep wave. There we go. They get the kill and a disastrous team fight for Secret. I really thought and let's see if they can catch out Weehaw as well. Or if Dendi's just gonna take the rune. Oh, let's see. He gets the invis. Weehaw's going down. Nothing for his troubles. And stable concoction. Chemical Rage is strong, but not that strong. So that was a disaster. That was a 5-man team wipe. They've actually just respawned because of how long it took.
Llama, I can't believe Weehaw went for that rune at the end there. That was beyond ballsy. That was suicidal, man. Like, they're still chasing you down. They just hit the sonic wave on you, and they're most likely gonna blink forward and try to do something. Taking that path to the side there, is just saying, I'm forfeiting my life for this rune, and
they didn't even get the rune
we saw, so. I don't know about that one.
I feel like it was extra surprising because there was no vision. If Secret had vision here, right, I would maybe understand. Maybe he saw the invis rune, he thought it would be his way out, checking their heroes, seeing a lack of detection, except on the Dazzle. You know, maybe you're like, this is my chance to escape. But there was no hope there, and it's just going to put Dendi further and further ahead. He's getting mad kills. He's 4-0-1. He's going to have an Orchid really soon, which of course sucks for your Doxia, albeit he's getting closer and closer to the Guardian Greaves, but you know, if you catch the Alk before he pops off, that Chemical Rage, pretty easy kill, I think, for a Quap. It's not where we're used to seeing Secret against Na'Vi.
Yeah, most certainly. Again, it's just not a spot that Secret want to be in either, for sure. And it's going to be getting better. I mean, again, Na'Vi's heroes are very aggressive. Have these tools within these heroes to be able to fight up against Secret anytime in their woods and just gang them up nonstop.
Yeah,
I think that's part of the reason why Secret's being forced to 4-man jungle / have some synergy time in the woods together. They look like they want to smoke, but even these smokes, it's very hard to isolate some of these targets. Like, if Dijavara spots them nicely, he's going to be able to get away with it.
You say this, but they're giving it a go onto the Dijavara, and it's going to be self-stun.
Oh,
very exciting.
It's so hard, again, like, their initiation comes in the form of a Wraith King, and now they're going to go Roche. This is a nice follow-up. You can get it.
It does look like Na'Vi not really aware of this, not even a remnant in the pit or something. Really well played, obviously enabled by Weehaw.
Oh, I don't know, man, I think they're aware.
Oh, as I say, we got a rocket. Weehaw's really low. Ichiro finally throws in the remnant, and yeah. There's gonna be a hookshot isolating Envy. It was a level 1 ult before, so he's gonna be dead again. They just need to actually pick him off. Dendi gets that kill. Yeah, the clockwork dies, but very much worth it. Ichiro runs through the wall twice. Big sonic wave coming up from Dendi. Pilot die. He's trying to live on the edge, but Dendi manages to find him, and now they'd have to think about going high ground. Dendi actually takes quite a few hits from the tower, but he, again, in typical fashion of this game, he has a DD. Weehaw, he's thinking about going in. He gets silenced, but he's just gonna be auto attacked down. Unstable, Chemical Rage does nothing here. Dendi actually blinks over and leaves Sinekko to get the kill, not managing to get the self-stun. Dendi playing way back up. Is Sinekko just solo killing Misery? Oh no, Dendi comes into his man.
Oh, and Puppy's dead too, I think. He doesn't have mana. Yeah. He's got 6 charges, but Sinekko's got a nuke.
Oh, Sinekko, it's nighttime. Oh, he actually gives it up. No, Sinekko, you've got to just go for it. You've gone ham. You have to go all the way, but instead, looks like he might be taking a tumble. There are a lot of heroes around here, and he goes down. I think when you dive that hard, you know you're going to die. So
yeah,
you just have to go for it.
I think he should have committed the silence with the magic stick and then used his mango for the void and just commit for the kill and get out. I mean, he doesn't lose the mango now, but he's still got mango and darkness.
It's, you know, it's 15 minutes in. I'm not sure your value mango. So, but as you said, it is a bad engagement's being taken for Secret. Now we see Na'Vi 5k ahead in net worth, 5,000 experience. And to me, this is almost more worrisome. When you look at the levels, Secret has people, a lot of them. Even Envy is only level 8, whereas we see Dijavara's level 10, Dendi's level 11. Both the supports, level 8 or above. I mean, this Nightstalker is level 9. It's really scary when you see a support Nightstalker that high level. And Hookshot gonna miss Axmo, I think, wanting the creep to be killed off by Dendi before he went for that. But they're gonna pop Nighttime, and that kind of, you know, it covers your shame.
No venture, no gain. Yeah, nothing really lost.
So if you're Secret, how do you come back from this? Obviously, we already talked in the draft that Na'Vi has the early aggression. They're putting it to work. It does feel like Secret, you know, I wouldn't say a Wraith King goes as hard carry as an Ember, but they certainly have a point in the game where I feel like the Darkseer will be online, will have his initiation, as well will EE, and obviously an Ice Blast into a vacuum is wombo combo. So do you think they just kind of try to wait to get those items on key heroes and then go for the fight?
I definitely think the items have a lot to do with it. Envy really wants his blade mill, and I think Weeha's got enough mana, enough gold. He's got 2k in the bank if he wants to finish the Solar Crest, although it doesn't look like that yet. Might just go for a Sand or something like that to buff his side points a little more, but do is what they just did actually. Even though it was nighttime, you can't really have all these cores sitting in one lane together without a purpose. Because they haven't taken any towers. Without tier 1 towers, entry into enemy woods like almost, especially against heroes like Nightstalker and Clockwork. It looks like they want to assemble for a 5-man push of some sort here, but I can't see this being very efficient.
And at the same time, Na'Vi's taking their tower on top. Exactly. Dendi already has his Orchid up. Seneko is working on probably the Ags, but maybe depending on how he sees this game going, could be a BKB instead. Betting it's the
Puppy.
Ags, though.
No, oh? He's not gonna...
Oh, okay. He's... yeah, he's rocking Tranquils and Wards. I mean, I didn't expect Puppy to have a lot of fall in this game, but it's rough for an AA. You are a hero that desperately wants that Aghanim Scepter, and you can build him in a way that he doesn't get that, but obviously the extra duration with how the Ags works and the fact that you're running a Wraith King and Alcohol, we're gonna see an engagement. Dendi actually throws out a little bit of a scream. They're all gonna dodge that Ice Blast. Archstyle looking like he's gonna be burnt down, but the rest of them are still full. Let's see what they can get. Ember Spirit on the backline picks up Vayne. I need to zoom all the way out because this team fight is hectic. Envy again caught out. This time he does have the second life. DJ Rogers running through all of them. He's stopping up Misery so he can't draw the wall vacuum combo. They get one life, and now Weeha, did he just self-stun? It looks like he did. Sonic Wave comes up. Misery, he manages to drop the wall, but no vacuum, and now Dendi's coming back in. The auto attacks also from DJ Raw with the hook shot. It's gonna be another huge set of kills for the lineup of Na'Vi, and they are just ripping through Secret.
Yep, so DJ Raw actually purchased Blink, pardon me, not DJ Raw, Weeha on the Alchemist. Yeah. That was a 2k gold item he was looking for, he just bought it at the side shop, and the result is they do get a tier 1 tower at the end of the day, but at what cost, really, right? I mean, yep. The Alchemist invested his money into a Blink Dagger now, so all they can do at this point, they don't have alternatives. All they can do is actually smoke into Na'Vi and hope that they're split up or isolate Dazzle somehow. That's how they want to approach these fights with the AA Blast connecting. And sadly, even though they got the Dazzle Snipe, they weren't able to connect the AA Blast on anybody in the last fight. And, of course, like, Na'Vi came in so strong from the side with the newly picked up items, the Orchids, as well as Ember coming in, Paste Rune.
Okay,
a lot of things were going awry for inside a Secret.
Ichiro played that perfectly. He was at the edges, got the Bane pickoff, and then he stunned up Misery. With no vacuum wall combo, there's just no wombo combo yet for Secret. I mean, yeah, Envy, he's a Wraith King with a blade mail. He doesn't hit like a truck yet. He doesn't hit hard and fast enough. So it's something where I think they need a lot more on him, and maybe not the position I think Secret was expecting to be in as well, because this Alc build, you mentioned it, the Blink, it often means that you think you're going to be initiating, you're going to be getting these pickoffs. I'm not so sure with the few items they have, but as you said, they take the opportunity, they've got the smoke up.
Yeah,
they...
this is, honestly, with these items that they have right now, this is all they can do. The only way they can come back is to force ridiculous fights that Na'Vi is not prepared for, and just hope they win. Actually, the alternative is, I guess, going for Roshan like this. Out through the woods, and then Na'Vi are keenly aware of it. Axmo throwing that preemptive rocket flare, and yeah, they're aware of it. So Secret's movements, as obvious they may be, Na'Vi realize it too.
Yeah, and they're gonna go for it. Okay, Roshan looks so confused when he's gonna catch a bit of damage. They send a rocket into their woods, you can see, for Na'Vi, taking a look around, and now it looks like they're planning on smoking up. I see pings. I don't see a smoke yet on anyone, so I'm not sure. Nope, that's just gonna be Na'Vi saying that they're going for it. We have the illusions picked up by Misery, and Roshan, he is actually getting pretty low, but immediately the lineup of Secret leaving the Roshan pit, they know better. They know they've missed a few fights, but they managed to get the hookshot onto Envy. He doesn't have a second life again. They need to help him out here. He pops that blade mail. It does a lot of damage to Axmo, and with the AA block, it looks like it's gonna be goodbye Clockwork, but Envy may fall in exchange. He's getting very low. One more auto attack. Ember Spirit ends up getting that. Misery drops a wall. It's a zoning wall. It's not the type that you want, and it looks like Na'Vi may just just chill and take this tower. Again, not an advantageous trade. I mean, Secret is so far behind that this looks advantageous, but you don't want to be losing MV over and over. 7,500 gold behind and 10,000 experience. Seneca is level 11.
Yeah, this is obviously a real, real problem for the side of Secret right now. Again, all they can do now is just rotate back to their lanes and wait for the next smoke or opportunity that all five heroes can assemble, because they're just not farming anything.
Yeah.
Not gonna come.
Now, I also wanted to talk about this Ember Spirit. Obviously, we all saw DJ-Ra had an awful lane in bottom. He is getting very close to that Battle Fury, and timings on Battle Fury this patch, like average timing, is 25 minutes. Considering DJ-Ra's lane, I'm really impressed. Albeit that stat usually includes someone going for drums in between, but still, he had like 7 CS in the laning phase.
Yeah.
So, yeah. I'm really impressed, and this feels like Na'Vi really have Secret's number. You mentioned it could be that they've scrimmed a bunch and they kind of knew what they were fighting into, but I have to say they're playing really well. Seneca, it is an early BKB. I thought I was crazy saying that, okay? I actually thought I was going to get mocked mercilessly for suggesting that Nightstalker might go BKB before the Ags here.
Actually, Seneca is one of the few players, I think he does this like all the time, I don't know. He just goes BKB over the Ags, and with Nightstalker is you really want both. But as a 4-position Nightstalker, most of the time, you're not the one that's in the middle of the fight trying to
get
spells. That's why they get the Aghanim, so you can just provide the vision. You know, if you have 4 other heroes that are playing with map pack, it's better than your one hero. I mean,
yeah.
If your one hero goes in with a BKB, you can provide a similar circumstance under...
I think it's also really nice here. Dendi's going for 1-2. They don't have a bunch of lockdown, and while the AA Blast does apply to you through BKB, the damage tick from Frostbite doesn't tick, and
oh,
we have a hookshot.
Nice blink.
Well played. He was silenced, but you can still blink away. But let's see, we have an engagement on the other side. Puppy, he's taking a lot of damage. They managed to pick off the Dazzle immediately, but Seneca going hard with that BKB onto Puppy. He throws out an Ice Blast. It's going to hit. Oh, DJ-Ra manages to dodge it. He does get the little effect applying. And on the sidelines, it looks like Puppy still going down. Misery now going to be chased. He's just going to try to TP up, but the Searing Chains managed to stop that. Axmo still very low, somehow alive. And Dendi, he has Sonic Wave. He's just trying to get his bomb over there. And now Seneca, he's going to take off a stun. But this guy, he is tanky. He is a Night Stalker. He manages to take a crit from Envy. He burns down, and it looks like Dendi doesn't want to go in on this one, so finally Secret taking a team fight, and you can see Envy's like, maybe we do Roshan, but I don't think they have enough in the tank, especially with Dendi having that Sonic Wave to just throw in the pit. So Secret showing signs of life, but it is still looking like a rough road for them.
I think I think that fight was actually a pretty big Na'Vi miss there. The way Soneko isolated the Ancient Apparition as the target and refused to cast any spells like the Silence when the AA Blast came out or something, it was real weird to me, because I understand that he can withstand the damage with the BKB against the Darkseer and Ancient Apparition. Even though he was zoning them, they already lost the Dazzle, and the teamfight was a mess because the Clockwork Hook didn't connect, and they obviously missed the Blink initiation on Weeha. Speaking of which, when you go on an Alchemist and he already popped the Chemical Rage, I don't actually see the point in the Orchid. I feel like you should just blink and then scream right away to cancel that potential blink coming out. But as it stands, Yao was able to react very, very fast and got out of that. So yeah, I don't know, Na'Vi were pretty split up in the fight that they should have had the advantage over, because they had the nighttime vision, they just placed the ward and...
And they're so far ahead. I mean, levels
exactly.
Superior. Yeah. I also wanted to point out that this is an Alc who has had stacks. I mean, obviously he's had a bit of a rough game. He's 2-5, but he only has 370 GPM. So, because I keep checking, going, what's your next item going to be? And he does finish up that Solar Crest, but he's not rocking a lot of new stuff. And actually, Envy's going to get his Blink Dagger up. So I think that Secret, they're getting themselves now into a point. I'm not quite sure that they can take Na'Vi on head-to-head, but they're getting there. And it looks like we're going to be seeing Misery going for that 4-star. I was kind of expecting a Blink Dagger here.
Against the Clockwork, 4-staff is like the must. Darkseer, because whenever you get isolated by Clockwork, you can't just assume that you're gonna tank like 5 seconds of battery assault. You have to get out of the cogs as soon as possible.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Yeah, it is something where obviously Blink great for initiation, but as you mentioned with Clockwork, you probably want your AA or your Bane to also be making a 4-staff to help whoever else gets stuck in the cogs. So Na'Vi gonna maybe think about going aggressively on the mid lane. Is that a smoke coming out again from Secret? I feel like they've used a lot of these, and we'll take a look-see. Yeah, they don't have another smoke for 10 minutes, but if they can pick off Seneca here again, This will be fantastic. I think it's a hard ask for them to catch out Dandy, but Pilai he does have that Fiend's Grip, and we haven't seen that yet. Envy initiates, but the immediate BKB coming out from Sineko, trying to make something happen since he's popped that BKB. We're gonna hear a stun coming out from Weehawk. Again, if they take out the Dazzle before this fight starts, but there's gonna be a hookshot onto Puppy. Oh, isolating him. Weehawk gets Sonic Wave down. The cause actually being will kill off the Ancient Apparition, and Envy's trying to stand and fight, but one life down, and Sineko gets the Shallow Grave. He'll probably fall here anyway, but that gives him a bit more time to go ham. And now Dandy's coming in, picks up the Bane. Envy, it looks like, is gonna be going down a second time as Dandy just pops that BKB. It doesn't care about your blade mail. A nice kill on the sidelines by Misery, but we have the TP coming in. Are they gonna chase? It doesn't look like they can quite catch up to him, Surged, especially since Disharad doesn't have much mana on him. So another good team fight coming out of Na'Vi, and they're gonna be very happy about that one. Big win. Transition it into maybe a top and a mid push.
This is somewhat of an interesting play. I don't think I should be going too in-depth about this kind of thing, but I found it weird that while they were fighting the four people on the side of Secret and wiping them at the bottom side there, we saw Misery. He actually vacuumed to execute the Sonego, who was like living away, running away with like 20 life points.
Mm-hmm.
And Dijara actually had a remnant there when he was porting into the creep. So I feel like if Sonego just spam ping and he was dying and told Dijara that he walked by a remnant in the remnant, Dijara, instead of TPing with bots for 3 seconds, he would have just remnanted back, and he would have actually had enough mana to Searing Chain as well, and that could have resulted in a 5-man wipe on the side of Secret.
I think
Sonego might be the quiet type, I don't know.
I have to imagine he's not. We've heard good reports that he really helps with this Na'Vi lineup. Clearly he plays really well. He did a lot of good work. Everybody, I think, has seen his Wyvern Havost play, where he's running around like a madman keeping Havost alive while Havost is just repeatedly engaging on like 10% health. But I feel like, as you said, it may have just been heat of the moment. Maybe Sineko was pinging it out, but Dichira had another kill in mind. He was, as you said, deep in the team fight on this side, trying to make sure that they got the kills on Envy and the Alk. So either way, we're going to be seeing them go in. Dendi, he's got his BKB. He's actually going to go for a Shiva's. No Aghanims this time, but Misery. Oh, they managed to catch him with the Searing Chains and a hookshot to boot. Okay, that was great prejudice.
Why not? You know, Na'Vi can actually. Do they have a medallion on them? I feel like they can actually go for
Yes, they have
Roche.
One on the Dazzle. They've had it for a while. Kind of his only item. But they're now 10,000 net worth ahead, 15,000 experience. This is, I believe. Okay, no, I don't have the stat on this one. I know it's under 10% of teams come back. I know the 20,000 stat is 1.5% of teams come back in art style. Doing some casual warden action. And I feel like Na'Vi, this game, I'm always a fan of co-op going Ags, but obviously they're having the spacing to take these team fights really on their terms or disengage, so she doesn't need to worry about having the ult up all the time, it seems. And that's really helping out this line of Na'Vi. I just feel like this whole game has been on their terms, even though Secret is repeatedly smoking.
Yeah. You might argue that Secrets just seem like they're forced to smoke. They don't have too many other options.
Yeah.
Between the blocking the camps and the neutrals and Sokka walking around in the first night and actually steering kills like that against Secret, a real surprise nonetheless, but there might be another engagement as Secret try to hold their base the best they can by replay.
Now, I have to say, I'm constantly impressed by how Sineko has played this. It's really hit or miss. I mean, I can't stress that enough. It's something where maybe you go for a kill, there's a TP rotation, and you dive too deep, and then you're off the map for most of your nighttime. It's not grand. So, we'll be seeing what's coming out here. Dichira, of course, as I pointed out earlier, he's picked up that baby crit. The Chrysalis is on the deck, and we'll be seeing. And now, Sineko going for that Aghanim Scepter. A little bit surprised they don't try to go for a pickup before this push, and yeah, as I say that, they end up backing out. Could be Roshan, and that's what Dendi seems to want.
I think they can do it. Of course, they are going up against an ancient apparition, so they have to be wary of that. They should have a sentry down. Yeah, they do have a sentry down. And actually spot out the A class, and here we are. They're going to back out. Yeah.
It's actually really funny, too. I feel like the Wombo combo from Secret in the Rosh Pit is way superior to Na'Vi, so maybe this will be the time to shine, but they have to actually go for it, and
Sineko, I feel like he should just pop the darkness, so take away the vision as much possible, because they know there's a fight here, but here we go.
Yeah, instead he just decides to run into them. He hasn't thrown out the silence yet. He's of course used that Void Envy. He does have two lives here, but he may be burning one very quickly, and he's not respawning in a great position. Tenneco just going ham. He's stopping the rest of them, but that is... Oh no, the self-stun on Weehaw! Tenneco's gonna be Fiends gripped up, immediately silenced by Dendi. He's now got his BKB active. He's going in. They pick up Envy in the back lines, and now it's looking like Weehaw to follow. I wouldn't be surprised if Secret just called a GG here, but Misery, he's gonna just manage to TP out, knowing they don't have anything. Hookshot already been used. That was just, I mean, I think Envy a little bit too far out, and the fact that the team backed El Seneco, okay, it's like a level 2 A blast. Yeah, it's not gonna kill
anyone.
Enough.
I'm still surprised that he didn't pop Darkness for the entire duration of that fight. Hey, if you don't need it, I guess not.
Yeah, save it for the uphill maybe was his thought process, although I agree with you, it's a bit weird, interesting. I feel like Secret just taking these engagements a bit poorly, maybe not... I mean, I've seen Envy play Wraith King a bunch, so I'm a little confused. It feels like he's trying to be too aggressive. Weehaw, I think that's the fifth self-stun I've seen this game.
Honestly, simply put, they're definitely not playing up to par of what people expect them to be. You know, over the last few days, I don't know if crumbling is the right word, but they haven't been able to connect their piece together, and yeah. Don't know what it is. Maybe the finals loss to OG and the majors really hurt them, but as it stands, they really are not playing up to par how they normally would. From the earlier TPs, the unnecessary reactions, and people just like getting caught overall the way they move around the map, it was so silly. Like, playing against Nightstalker, you'd imagine Secret's one of the best teams against these kind of early aggressions. Just be able to calculate movements and expect where level 3, level 4 Nightstalker would be, but you just get caught out from 20% life points, their own woods and stuff. It just doesn't seem very Secret-esque.
Yeah, and I mean, we've touched on this already. Clearly Na'Vi's at a 15,000 net worth lead, 20,000 experience, but I can't remember the last time I saw a game where Envy was, you know, 6th, 7th on the net worth chart.
Yeah, he's usually one of the best, one of the most efficient farmers, somebody who farms very aggressively. Of course, again, you are limited to a Wraith King this game. You don't have a Battle Fury to start. You're not going to be creeps right away. And as we can see, even at bottom, he's struggling to clear out creeps one by one. You know, he's got a Blade Mail and a Blink Dagger, nothing that really helps him CS. But I do not want to take away credit from Na'Vi, though. I mean, it's not the first or second time they're coming back this week. The fact that, he's been playing really, really well, and his positioning has been super.
Can you really say they've come back multiple times this week? I feel like it's that they're back.
Nah, man. Na'Vi and Alliance, they're back like 3 to 4 times a week, let me tell you. Depends on the match count.
Excellent. That means that you'll be able to see them at a Twitch channel near you. Either way, Misery, oh, EC's old style. Okay, I also have to comment on this on Misery. I feel like it's a bit of a mistake against an Orchid, an early Orchid on the Quap, and of course this Crippling Fear, which is 8 seconds now at nighttime. How does he not have Guardian Greaves? I understand you need the Blink, the Force Staff, to get away from the Clockwork Blink for initiation, but I feel like Guardian Greaves could have saved a number of teamfights here.
Well, the thing with the Dispel is it's only on him, and to be completely honest, I feel like right now, what's stopping him from casting spells is actually not the fear. I do agree, normally that's a concern. This game, it seems like all the other squishy targets are going down first, and he doesn't have to watch out too much for himself. If anything, I feel like maybe Blink Dagger is actually the right choice this game, because he's the one that's so far in the back lines and they never go for him. And honestly, the other thing is probably BKB. I think BKB is really good against Na'Vi this game, and Lotus Orb is also a really fine choice.
Yeah, and it looks like Clockwork, speaking of Lotus Orb, is building up one for his team. It could also be a Lincoln's, I guess, but it's really nice, I think, against a lot of these stuns coming out that all, I mean, because Secret's so single target, I feel like the Lotus Orb here could just really be what helps them siege the high ground and make sure that Dendi isn't in too much of a pickle. So, and
both teams, a lot of the spells. Like, with Lotus Orb, you can remove the Orchid, you can remove Chains, you can remove the Cripple Clear, the Void Slow, there's a lot of tools to bounce back as well. And as you said, on the side of Secret, there's the Star Blast, Alchemist Stun, all Bane spells are single target.
Yeah, and Cold Feet and so on. It's not great. But I also wanted to point out the Aghanim's just needs to be flown out to Nightstalker, so I think that's on its way. He's had a gem for the duration anyway, because Oddstyle's, you know, a charitable dazzle. He's gonna give you a gem no matter what happens, and Oddstyle also may be finishing treads now. Could be something else, but he's managing, despite his team's overwhelming net worth lead, to be second to last in net worth.
He's content. I mean, there's 4 heroes on the side of Na'Vi right now, which are above 10k net worth at 35 minutes. Yeah. This is a very, very nice spot to be in. And wow, that crit coming out of Diarra just melting the Optimus down. Half-life points, forcing him to camp rage even under his tower.
Oh, and he might actually be in a really bad spot. Are they just gonna auto-attack him down? The Sonic Wave used to pick him up. He's on the deck now for 50 seconds. How is he gonna, how are they gonna take this fight? I mean, he's a good portion of their base defense. Envy, he's thrown out that Wraith Fire Blast, but there's gonna be an AA Blast at the same time. Envy, he's being picked up. They managed to catch out Alt-Style. Bane goes down in the back lines. Envy is getting very low, and they're just gonna focus on this tower. They don't need to actually pick off anyone here. They can just take the base and win the game.
Yeah, and looks like they're gonna be able to slow but still whittle down the base here. Not much rebuttal coming out, AA Blast is down, and Wraith King has his tools up, but all he can do is just go in there and suicide and hope his second life does a little.
Yeah. So we're gonna be seeing Envy, he's going for it, he throws out a Wraith Fire Blast, he actually can't get it off, they get another beautiful wall vacuum combo, but Envy, he's getting low, he's taking a lot of damage, he does have that second life, he's trying to fight with Sonaco, he's got Ion Shells on him, are they gonna at least kill the Nightman himself? It doesn't look like it, and now Envy, he is isolated out, Dejiroff tearing him apart. And he's gonna go down. He does use that buyback. We have Pylite Die on the sidelines. Doesn't have that Fiend's Grip, but let's see if they can at least save the Rax. And at the same time, MVP's TP'd into death. Oh, Alk is coming back in Weehaw, and we see the GG call. Weehaw wants to at least get someone, but he's heal bombed. And that's gonna be it. I mean, it wasn't that quick, but it was a quickly executed game from the lineup of Na'Vi. Doing fantastically there. I mean, final thoughts, Clairvoyance.
It really seemed like Na'Vi had their pieces together, and Secret just were pretty jumbled from the 5-minute mark onwards. I mean, they had this aggressive trialing thing going on, they were